Hi, I'm Andy.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Ben.
Welcome to the BRIC. We began our build with the main entryway, with the iconic Bronco Peak on the right and the Pro Shop on the left. You'll also notice the pressure-activated entry gates, similar to the biometrically activated ones at the BRIC. Now we walk toward the equipment checkout and functional lockers. This area is complete with lounge seating and several variations of working water fountains. It also holds our five group fitness studios. These include Studio A, the Mind and Body Studio, Studio B, the MMA Studio, Multi-Purpose Studios C and D, and Spin Studio E.
Let me demolish Andy at a ping pong match real quick. We began our design process by establishing the 1.5:1 scale and mapping the perimeter of the building, as well as where each floor began. We completed the majority of calculations and outlines in a lengthy planning phase, so the rest of the build came much more easily.
Alright, on the second floor we have another training area complete with bathrooms, mirrors, and water fountains. We also have this floor's main attraction, the courts. We have a multi-purpose court suitable for indoor soccer, basketball, and volleyball, as well as three other courts primarily dedicated to basketball. The layout of this floor was especially difficult due to the complex markings on the court floors. We eventually settled on using redstone, one of the only materials in Minecraft that is completely flat and thin enough to look like a painted line. Lighting was also a difficulty. On the exterior of the building and on many other floors, we were able to use carpet or shulker boxes to hide our light sources. This was not possible on the second floor. Instead, we used strategically placed pressure plates of the same floor material to cover sea lanterns. Now, it's time for a quick lap around the track. This floor was simple to build, but complex to detail. Each workout station required a different structure and different materials. We ended up using everything from anvils, to carpets, to wither skulls, and end rods. On this floor, we also used an alternative material for the mirrors, ice. While they're a better option than banners, which take up a block of airspace, they also melt under high light levels. Thus, they require strategic light placement. Let's enjoy the view.
As we finish our lap around the track, why don't we take a quick wind-down walk on the treadmill before exploring the rest of the third floor. Oh, hey guys!
Hey!
Hey.
You'll notice each machine is different. All of the machines are modeled after specific counterparts in the brick and are positioned correspondingly. From here, we can not only see the quartz, but also the deliberately staggered light strips and the skylights. You'll also notice that the ceiling is slightly slanted, as it is in actuality. This elevator presented a special challenge because it had to fit right next to the wall on multiple floors and still have redstone activation mechanisms. On the first floor, we have three locker rooms as well as the ASI offices. Each office was given a personal touch, like a potted cactus or a flower.
I think I'm going to order my favorite drink at Jamba Juice, the Strawberry Swell. Sarah? Oh, thanks! Now let's hit the pool.
The pool is unique in that much of it is angled at a diagonal. This creates a problem in Minecraft, since the diagonal length of a block is greater than the 1 meter length of each side. For example, 4 meters diagonally would not equal 4 blocks placed at a diagonal. Instead, by using trigonometry, we know a 3-block hypotenuse equals roughly 4.24 meters diagonally. We made a spreadsheet of other common triangles and their calculated hypotenuses to quickly find what a given dimension would be closest to in terms of diagonal blocks. Using the measuring tool on Google Maps and many reference photos, we were able to recreate the pool, as well as its surrounding buildings and unique landscaping. The palm trees were also a fun addition and a rare opportunity to use ancient debris as a material. We thought it was important to construct the buildings surrounding the brick, such as the Darlene May Gymnasium, as seen on the left, and the Kellogg Gymnasium. We took the time to add details such as the outside wheelchair ramp, blue light phones, and eucalyptus lane. Additionally, we took special care to add the right foliage on all sides of the building, including the front, where we added the underbuilding landscaping and the amphitheater.
We all put a lot of work into this. Over 206 hours and 264,000 blocks worth. All of this during the most challenging semester of our academic careers. Thanks for joining us on this journey.
Bye.
Thanks for watching.
Bye, everyone.
Thanks for watching. Peace out.